to Take Care guys, this is Saurabh here and today we are back with a new video. And in this video we are going to tell you, we are going to compare the OnePlus 2 and the Utopia on the paper, via their specifications. Well, OnePlus 2 is in the market for quite a long time and is still is now invite free, so you can buy that anytime you want, not like the invite system. And Utopia has been launched a few days ago and now is available for pre-order in Amazon, but will be shipped after 26th of December. So, a lot of consumers are now confused because which one to choose. Both of them are priced at exact 25,000, 24,999 to be specific. But they have some differences. Although they have the same processor and the same amount of RAM, but they do have some differences. And I'm here right now to tell you what the differences are actually there and what does it actually mean to you. And now first I'm going to start with the similarities between both the phones. Well, the similarities are here like the processor. Well, both of them are powered by the Snapdragon 810, which is an octa-core processor, and the GPU is the Adreno 430. So the graphics unit and the processing unit is the same for both the phones, which means you will get more or less the same performance on both the phones. And in case of the RAM, well, the RAM for both the phones is 4GB, which is huge for any mobile at this price point. So apart from these two similarities, there is nothing such similar in both of them. Well, come to the differences first. Well, come to the internal storage of the phone. In case of internal storage, the OnePlus 2 has 64GB of internal storage and it's an eMMC 5.0 storage, probably made by SanDisk, and there is no further expansion option. But in case of Utopia, the 32GB inbuilt memory is there and there is an option of upgrading the memory via the microSD card. So as for me as a user, I would personally I have no problem with having a 64GB onboard memory or a 32GB via the expansion slot. But it's entirely up to you how do you choose to store your data on the phone. Like 64GB definitely is a huge size, huge space for storing data, movie, songs, etc., etc. But also, if you want more than that, if you think that 64GB won't be enough for you, then you can go for the Utopia and choose the 32GB model and then expand it up to 128GB or probably 64GB. There is no confusion for that. But minimum 64GB is there for upgradation for you, so you can easily do that. Now come to the camera. Well, in case of camera, both of them are powered by Sony sensors. In case of OnePlus 2, there is a laser focusing unit. And in case of Utopia, it has a 21 megapixel back shooter with an 8 megapixel front shooter, probably made by the Sony IMX320. And in case of OnePlus 2, there is a 30 megapixel back shooter with 5 megapixel front shooter. Both of the cameras on the back, both of the back cameras of the phones can shoot 4K videos. But in case of I would recommend you the Utopia, because the front shooter in the Utopia is quite good than the OnePlus 2. And also there is an option of click the selfies via the fingerprint scanner on the Utopia, that makes it even more awesome than the OnePlus 2. But first of all, let me tell you, I'm not a megapixel freak. I don't really think that having greater megapixels will give you greater image quality. It is entirely up to you what you're gonna choose, but 30 megapixel for OnePlus 2 is also a very good thing, and Utopia on the other hand, 21 megapixel sensor is also a good thing. So it's now entirely up to you that what you're looking at, because I don't think that 21 megapixel and 30 megapixel will make a huge difference in picture quality. In case of resolution, there will be differences, but in case of quality, a megapixel is not a benchmark of qualities. So now come to the second thing, is that the body. Well, in case of Utopia, they have provided you a metal body frame, and in case of OnePlus 2, they are still stuck with the sandstone finish. So that's a little bit drawback, I would say, for OnePlus 2, because in metal bodies are even more stronger than the sandstone finish in the OnePlus 2. Well, now in terms of operating system, well, here is also some similarities and dissimilarities. The similarity is that both of them run on Lollipop, but the dissimilarity is that in case of OnePlus 2, it runs on the Oxygen OS, which is the OnePlus own OS, own ROM, and in case of the Utopia, it runs on the Cyanogen Mod 12.1. Well, Cyanogen is a worldwide known company for making custom ROMs for each and every phone, so definitely my trust would be go with this Cyanogen Mod, although OnePlus own ROM, the Oxygen OS, is not that bad, but I will definitely choose cyanogen mod over the Oxygen OS. Now coming to the battery, well, both of the phones have the non-replaceable batteries, but in case of OnePlus 2, it has a 3300 milliampere hour lithium polymer battery, and on the other hand, Utopia has the 3000 milliampere lithium polymer battery. Well, definitely OnePlus 2 have a big advantage in this section of the battery, but both of the 3000 milliampere on the Utopia is not that much bad, and there are also options of using it on a battery saver mode, on a performance mode, or on general mode. So if you really want to have extra juice on your phone in the Utopia, there is an option of using the battery saver mode so that you can use the phone for quite a long time. And there is also such options in the OnePlus 2. So I don't think that extra 300 milliampere on the OnePlus 2 is going to give it a huge boost. Well, the huge boost for Utopia is in the display section. The display section is it's quite a bit troublesome to choose which one is the best, because on the OnePlus 2 you are getting the 1080p LTPS IPS display with the 401 PPI alongside protected by a Corning Gorilla Glass 4. But in case of Utopia, there is no such protection like Corning Gorilla Glass. There is a protection of Corning Concord Glass, but the display is great by as it is having a OGC solution display from Sharp and having a resolution of 2K, which means 565 PPI. So it's a great thing for Utopia having a 2K display at a price tag of 25,000, and it's the lowest phone having the 2K display at a price tag of this. Well, it's an entirely personal choice of which phone are you taking, because display is an is your entirely personal choice which display would you prefer. Would you prefer a display that has the best screen protection right out there, or another display which has the best resolution out there but having not such great protection? Well, although UDel Ventures is providing you a free screen guard with the Utopia, but there are a lot of people who doesn't want to use any other screen guard over their phone, and they prefer the stock protection given by the company. So it's entirely up to you which display you actually choose. Would you prefer a 2K display or a Full HD display with a Corning Gorilla Glass 4 protection? Well, for me, I don't think that the 2K display or the 1080p display varies really affects me that much, because 401 PPI for me is also a great option, and having the Corning Gorilla Glass 4 is an added advantage. But if you really tell me to pick one phone among both the phones, well, I would choose the Utopia, because there are a few things that Utopia has over the OnePlus 2. The first one is the service availability. Well, the after-sales service of OnePlus is not that great. I'm personally a new user. I use the Eureka, and I faced some problem with my Eureka, and I called the UDel Ventures and got the replacement of the phone immediately within a week. So I know that how you works, and you the after-sales service of you is quite great. And also, in case of Utopia is giving you an option of having the earphones by House of Marley. So that's a great thing to have. The headphones are quite great. So these are some advantages of Utopia. And also, if you are opting out the Utopia via Amazon and via EMI, you are going to have 1,000 less in the SBI EMI option. And also, if you choose that you are going to get the Utopia 2 in the next year, you will also get 40% discount of the price of the Utopia that you have bought right now. So over and all, a little bit advantage of these things makes Utopia my personal choice for buying. But it's entirely up to you which one you do choose, because the display is the major difference for both the phones. One phone has a 1080p display with a Corning Gorilla Glass 4 protection, and the other one has a 2K display with no protection at all. But the company is giving you a screen guard that might be a tempered glass as well, but I'm not sure of that. But in case of the display is the main difference between both the phones, and if you choose one, choose wisely, because at time you may miss the 2K display of the Utopia because you are opting the OnePlus 2, and at times you may miss the Corning Gorilla Glass 4 protection of the OnePlus 2 because you have opted out the Utopia. So choose wisely. First of all, think which display is you really want, then choose a phone. So this was all for today, guys, and again thanks for watching the video. If you liked our video, do subscribe to our channel and press the thumbs up button. If you don't like the video, do give us a thumbs down button. And if you have any query regarding both the phones or any other technical issues, do let us know via the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.